program of the evening is a screecht which we showed not so very long ago, but due to demand, we're bringing it back to you again. This is a screecht that was done in the home of Dick and Kate Dineen in 1992. So for the rest of the night, I hope you'll enjoy the singing and the music.
Very kind invitation, and we have just had a selection of music from on my left, Colin Donoghue, Johnny McCarthy, Seamus Buckley, and Tony Dineen. Now, the idea behind all this came from the man of the house, Dick Dineen himself, and here to introduce the whole program for the evening is Dick Dineen himself.
Well, I want to welcome you all here anyway this evening for a bit of a dance and a sing song. And I just got an idea that we'd make a tape for a couple of hours. And
Monday.
I invited a few of my friends around there, and I might have a few enemies after. Maybe that I didn't invite more, but the house is small. And because we do the best we can, so I was, we'd be carrying on with a few songs now, next maybe.
No, we'll do a bit of traveling around the countryside, around the neighbourhood, and our first stop, we'll take a trip up to a place in County Clare by the name of the 6 Mile Bridge, and I'd like to introduce to you Finola Dineen. And of course Finola is no stranger to Macomb, she's a Bendon lady, by a native of Bendon actually, herself. So we'll be taking a widespread area around the country here for the evening, and we'll be introducing some very nice singers to you, some fine musicians, some fine singers, and lots of crack. So I hope you'll relax and enjoy yourself for the next couple of hours here at Dick and Katie's invitation. So Finola, when you're ready, please. And she'll be accompanied by her husband, Tony.
Lovely.
No, get on the wrong one.
Mary left her father's home.
ladies and gentlemen, for our next song, we'll have Tony Dineen himself accompanied on the guitar, and I think he'll introduce the song himself. So we'll leave it over to Tony now for the next song.
This is a song called The Lark in the Morning. I don't know much about it. I'd have Paddy Riley sing it one time anyway, so give it a blast.
The lark in the morning, she rises off her nest. She goes off in the evening with the dew all on her breast. And like the jolly ploughboy, she whistles and she sings. She goes home in the evening with the dew all on her wings. Oh, Roger the ploughboy, he is a dashing blade. He goes whistling and singing in yonder deep shade. And he met with dark eyed Susan, she's handsome, mighty clear. She's far more enticing than the birds all in the air. The lark in the morning, she rises off her nest. She goes home in the evening with the dew all on her breast. And like the jolly ploughboy, she whistles and she sings. She goes home in the evening with the dew all on her wings. As they were coming home from the rakes of the town, the meadow was all mown and the grass had been cut down. And they should chance to tumble all on the new mown hay. Well, it's kiss me now or never, the bunny lass did say. The lark in the morning, she rises off her nest. She goes off in the evening with the dew all on her breast. And like the jolly cowboy, she whistles and she sings. She goes home in the evening with the dew all on her wings. When 20 long weeks were over and past, her mummy asked the reason why she'd taken round the ways. It was the pretty cowboy, this fair maid had say, for he asked me to tumble all on the new old hay. The lark in the morning, she rises off her nest. She goes home in the evening with the dew all on her breast. And like the jolly ploughboy, she whistles and she sings. She goes home in the evening with the dew all on her wings. Here's help to you ploughboys, wherever you may be, who like to have a bunny lass a-sittin' on each knee. And with a pint of good strong porter, he'll whistle and he'll sing, for the ploughman is as happy as a prince or a king. The lark in the morning, she rises off her nest. She goes off in the evening with the dew all on her breast. And like the jolly ploughboy, she whistles and she sings. She goes off in the evening with the dew all on her wings.
Now, as we said at the outset, ladies and gentlemen, we take a trip around the countryside. Next stop, Inchigeela. So, I'd like to introduce a great friend of mine from the Inchigeela area. Man now residing in town here, Patrick Moynihan.
Sweet little town they call Belfast, apprentice to trade I was bound. And many an hour, sweet happiness, have I spent in that neat little town. A sad misfortune came over me, which caused me to stray from the land. Far away from my friends and relations, to follow the black velvet band. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I thought her the queen of the land. With her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. I took a stroll down Broadway, meaning not long for to say. When who should I meet was this pretty fair maid come a-traipsing along the highway. She was both fair and handsome, her neck it was just like a swan, and her hair it hung over. over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I thought her the queen of the land. With her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. Before the judge and the jury, next morning I had to appear. The judge, he says to me, "Young man, your case, it is proven clear. We'll give you 7 years penal servitude to be spent far away from the land, far away from your friends and relations, betrayed by the black velvet band." Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I thought her the queen of the land. With her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. So come all you jolly young fellows, a warning take by me. If you are out on the town, me lad, beware of those pretty colleens. They'll feed you with strong drink, me lad, till you are unable to stand. And the very first thing that you'll know is you've landed in Van Diemen's land. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I taught her the queen of the land. With her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band.
Well, now it's time for to have a song for the man of the house himself. And I think, seeing that we're here at the bridge at Massetown in Macroom, the title of the song is very appropriate for the occasion, I think. So, Dick will sing Mount Massey, the Flower of Macroom.
Go on, Dick.
How I long to remember those bright days of yore, when with pleasure I them did beguile. The friends that frequented my own cabin door, and the comrades I loved when a child. How I long to roam by Massey's green groves, and to poach by the light of the moon. I hope once again for to view her domain, Mount Massey, the Flower of Macroom. So chums, come with me, and it's there you will see the apples and cherries in bloom. And it's you I'll invite where I first saw the light, Mount Massey, the Flower of Macroom. In the sweet summer time, when the weather was fine, what fun we'd have there at the gate. The colleens would smile as they sat on the stile, while their sweethearts some love tales relate. When dancing was over, we'd stroll through the park, each lad with his lassie in bloom. That spot of my birth, there's no place on earth like Mount Massey, the Flower of Macroom. So chums, come with me, and it's there you will see the apples and cherries in bloom. And it's you I'll invite where I first saw the light, Mount Massey, the Flower of Macroom. So now I must roam far away from my home, and cross o'er the deep raging seas, and leave friends behind who are beloved and kind, and the colleen that dearly love me. Though fortune may smile far away from our isle, sure I hope that the day will come soon when we'll stroll once again by that lovely demesne, Mount Massey, the flower of Macroom. So chums, come with me, and it's there you will see the apples and cherries in bloom. And it's you I'll invite where I first saw the light, Mount Massey, the flower of Macroom.
Well, now, for our next stop, we'll go to Kerrigan-Emmett this time, ladies and gentlemen, for a man that's very well known in the music business. He's the band leader himself of the Blackwater Sound. There's no need to introduce him. Peter Lane, ladies and gentlemen. Continue with another song, ladies and gentlemen, from a man from the Kerrigafoca district. And we'll call him Jean McCarthy for the next song.
Last night, when we all alone by the banks of the Vine, some soldiers were calling far away. There was one soldier lad with his face pale and sad. To his sweetheart these words he did say, for tonight is our last night together, for the dearest and nearest must part, for a soldier must roam to the end of the world with his thoughts on his loving sweetheart. As we strolled hand in hand through the meadow, where we first fell in love, you and I, where you taught me to love you, sweet Molly, now teach me to tell you goodbye. For tonight is our last night together, For the dearest and nearest must part. For the soldier must roam to the end of the world, put his thoughts on his loving sweetheart. And perhaps I may fall in the battle. What more can a brave soldier do? And my last dying wish will be Molly, my mother, my country, and you. For tonight is our last night together. For the dearest and nearest must part. For a soldier must roam to the end of the world, with his thoughts on his loving sweetheart. And chin chin.
Now, we have here with us one of our older folk from just over the hill here in Kilcorney, in a place called O'Bain.
Yes, yes.
Anyway, can you sing us a song before we leave you?
I will try anyway.
Yeah, good man. Are you on?
Very solid, yes, yes. One fine summer day for amusement I stretched that mountain so famous called Musharmore. To view the grand plains all around me, I gazed on the prospect from there was most grand to behold. With heartfelt amazement I stood meditating to the fervent vocation of the young and the old that congregated round that holy elevation that was blessed by a saint that lived there long ago. At the foot of this mountain there springs a pure fountain, a well of unbounded ecstasy flows, where hundreds and thousands in prayer do surround it, supplicating profoundly to the God they adore. And there's not in this nation a holier high station than the spot consecrated by the Saint John of yore. I'm quite well aware 'twould relax the greatest pains that any human being did e'er undergo. From the top of this mountain there springs a... From the top of this mountain, if the sky wasn't cloudy, you'd see the most of Cork County and the core of Kildare, the Galtis, the Meigs near Killarney's Grand Lakes, the Mangerton Peak and the Gap of Dunlow, Cork Harbour and Queenstown, Spike Island and Monkstown, the bleaches of London and Glenmire's sunny groves. Mostly the entire of the whole British island you'd perceive from the height of sweet Musharmore. From the parishes surrounding, all parties are crowding, such a grand train of ladies you ne'er saw before. Were the Milstery classes, the Kilcorney Dashers, and Balnagree Sheshkina and Dunamore. The Clownderhood maidens, I attest, were the fairest, their equals in grandeur I didn't behold. They were admired by all strangers, they were so engaging, and last St. John's Day at sweet Musharmore. I viewed all around and examined those crowds, I espied a fair maid, and she standing alone. I pondered in mind for a very long time, thinking she might be the goddess of love. My poor heart was panting, and to her advancing, each lock of her hair hung in ringlets like gold. Her sparkling bright beauty attracted me greatly, and an arrow of Cupid inflicted in my core. I saluted this maid, she seemed a bonair, and into a beer tint along we did go. We sat on sedate, and I asked her her trait, and the answer she made was, whatever you chose. A bottle of brandy, I told the landlady, and this damsel, she paid down 10 shillings in gold, saying, drink and be merry, as we're not in a hurry, and I kissed and embraced my own fair Callinog. When I and this maid a few glasses had drained, I asked her quite plain, would she come with me home? I vowed and declared that my bride her I'd make, and the parochial clergy would make one of us both. From all harm and danger and safety I'd place her, on her fingers I'd place costly rings of bright gold. As for bread, beef and bacon and claret to table, and for life without failure I would her console. She answered and said that she liked well my sayings, though her father had for her a long fortune in store. But my blandimonial speeches and poetical genius did induce this fair maid for to be all my own. Until eager aspirations had lessened my sensations, and the beverage overcomes me through all the sport, that relaxed my sensations and improvocations regarding the praise of sweet Musharamur.
Now, we'll move up the street this time for a song from one of our neighbours up the road here, John Buckley. And John is going to sing The Blacksmith. And
20 years ago last Christmas came a tempter to my wife, stole the only flower I cherished, and I vowed I'd have her life. In the street one day I met him, in my eyes that villain grinned. Then the curse of fear came o'er me, 'twas on that very day I sinned. Sure I dream as the hammer strikes the anvil, and I dream as the sparks light on the floor of my blue-eyed turtle dove. She's the only girl I love, as she stood outside that good old smithy door. 12 months passed, then came my trial. In the court I saw my wife, and I heard her beg for mercy when they sentenced me for life. 12 long years I read her letters, the only comfort I can tell. When I heard that she was dying, 'twas then my lonely spirits fell. Sure I dream as the hammer strikes the anvil, and I dream as the sparks light on the floor of my blue-eyed turtle dove. She's the only girl I love, as she stood outside that good old smithy door. Then one night I dodged the warders, o'er the prison wall I sprang, landed home footsore and weary at the breaking of the dawn. She was glad, so glad to see me. In my arms that night she died. Then the warders rushed the doorway, and they found me there inside. When they saw the lifeless body, and I kneeling on the floor, they said, "Jack, me boy, we'll trust you. Come back when you've laid her low." Sure I dream as the hammer strikes the anvil, and I dream as the sparks light on the floor of my blue-eyed turtle dove. She's the only girl I love, as she stood outside that good old smithy door.
No, so this time we have a long-distance lorry driver now, and a man who is a great friend of the provider of the premises. And no doubt they'll have good crack tomorrow about all this when they'll meet. But anyway, Danny Kiley is going to give us a little bit of a song here, ladies and gentlemen. And
I have sought to discover a haven of rest, where the sun sinks by night in the land of the west. I dwelt with the red man in green forest bowers, or the wild rolling prairie bespangled with flowers. I hie to the north where the hardy pine grow, may the wolf and the bear and the bleak winter slow. I have roamed through all climates, but none could I see like the green hills of Cork and my home by the Lee. Beautiful city, charming and pretty, beautiful. beautiful city, my home by the Lee. Old feudal castle stands out on the Rhine that flow through the land of the olive and wine. There is freedom and wealth in all spots of the earth to the heart that can call it the land of its birth. But of all their fair counties, the dearest to me are the green hills of Cork and my home by the Lee. Beautiful city, charming and pretty, beautiful city, my home by the Lee.
It's time we're going to introduce two young ladies of the house, the two sisters, Kathleen and Margaret. First of all, Kathleen, I think, is going to sing The Wind in the Willows.
Lovely. As I was out walking one morning in spring, I met with some travellers in an old country lane. One was an old man, a second a maid, and the third was a young boy. He smiled and he said, with the wind in the willows and the birds in the sky, there's a bright sun to warm us wherever we lie. We have bread and fishes and a jug of red wine to share on our journey with all of mankind. My name is Joseph, this is Mary, my wife, and this is our young son, who is our delight. We travel the whole world by land and by sea to tell all the people how we can be free. But sadly I left them in the old country lane, for I knew I would never see them again. With the wind in the willows and the birds in the sky, there's a bright sun to warm us wherever we lie. We have bread and fishes and a jug of red wine to share on our journey with all of mankind.
On top of the world.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason is clear, it's because you are near. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I've seen. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love put me at the top of the world. Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves on the trees and the judge of the breeze, there's a place that sounds of happiness for me. There is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love put me at the top of the world.
Woo! time, we have a special request for Gene McCarthy of Carrigafoca to give us the tiddlyoni.
Russians have come out of late. No one comes every season. One came out the other night. Sure, I can't tell the reason. No one came out the other night. The night was sad and lonely. And I went and I bought the swallowtail coat and I called it my tiggeryoni. Oh, sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. Sing Rex for lal, for loni. Sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. And the lad with the tiggeryoni. As I was walking down the street, I met a sad disaster. I bought a pair of skating boots and became a skating master. Now the night was cold and freezing hard. The lake was frozen over, and the ice it bent and down. I went and I wet my tiggeryoni. Oh, sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. Sing Rex for lal, for loni. Sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. And the lad with the tiggeryoni. A lady who was standing by, on me she took compassion. She said, young man, come into the fire, if you want to dry your fashion. I took consent and in I went. The fire was burning slowly. Ah, she cried, young man, stand back from the fire and don't burn your tiggeryoni. Oh, sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. Sing Rex for lal, for loni. Sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. And the lad with the tiggeryoni. The night got fine, the moon shone bright. The maid and I went courting. And just outside her father's gate, we heard two donkeys roaring. Her father had a little dog. They used to call him Tony. And every time I kissed the maid, he bit my tiggeryoni. Oh, sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. Sing Rex for lal, for loni. Sing Rex for lal, for lal, for lal. I'm the lad with the tiggeryoni. I once took a lady out to dine. She was a flapper in the coal yard line. She was fond of cakes and wine, but I was fonder of me 4 and 9. 4 and 9, a back above a dollar. 4 and 9, take a tip from me. Never take a lady out to dine when all in her pocket is but 4 and 9. She first took me up to the castle hotel. With her little finger pressed the bell. She cried oysters and I cried wine, but I squeezed my fist upon my 4 and 9. 4 and 9, a back above a dollar. 4 and 9, take a tip from me. Never take a lady out to dine when all in your pocket is but 4 and 9. First she called for her oxtail soup, then she tried to loop the loop. She had a right eye fixed on mine, but I had the other and me 4 and 9. 4 and 9, a back above a dollar. 4 and 9, take a tip from me. Never take a lady out to dine when all in her pocket is but 4 and 9. Now up comes the waiter full of glee. He says, you'll pay this bill to me. He had his right eye fixed on mine, but I squeezed my fist upon my 4 and 9. 4 and 9, a back above a dollar. 4 and 9, take a tip from me. Never take a lady out to dine when all in her pocket is but 4 and 9. Now up comes the boss in a hell of a tear. He hit me a kick, but I won't say where. And out the window I sailed so fine, but I landed in the street with my 4 and 9. 4 and 9, a back above a dollar. 4 and 9, take a tip from me. Never take a lady out to dine when all in her pocket is but 4 and 9. And
thank you. Hello.
Now, so this time, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to the parish of Clondalkin for our next artist, a man that's very well known for other gymnastics, I suppose we should say, and an all-round athlete, an all-round entertainer in every respect of the word. And this time he's going to accompany himself on the accordion, John Kelleher of Clonderhead, with the star of the County Down.
I would like anybody here to join in the chorus, please, if they're just the maid of the County Down, if they want to just join in.
In Banbridge Town, in the County Down, one morning last July, down a bowling green came a collie and sweet, as she smiled as she passed me by. She looked so sweet from her bare 2 feet to the stems of her nut-brown hair. But at folks in Ashore, I shook me head to see I was really there. From Banbridge Bay of the Derry came a girl with a Dublin town. No maid of sea like the brown colleen that I met in the County Down. As she onward sped, sure I scratched me head with a feeling a looking rare. And I says I to a passerby who's a maid with a nut brown hair. She's scarlet maiden, she's a sissy, she's a gin of Ireland's crown. Young Rosie McCann from the banks of the Ban, she's a star of the County Down. From Battery Bay of the Derry Cape, a girl in the Dublin town. That I met in the County Down. At the harvest fair, she'll surely be there, so I'll dress in my Sunday clothes, with my shoe shiny bright and my hat caught right, with a bride for my broken rose. No pipe well spoke, no hot I'll yoke, till my plough colour rust colour brown, till a smiling bride be at my fireside, says the star of the County Down. From Bansy Bay of the Derry Cape, from Galway to Dublin Town. He joined the Flying Colleen in 1986 with Cork, with Charlie Mylan, Tipperary with Jaleen, arrested by Free Staters and sentenced to die. Farewell to Tipperary, to the Galty Mountain Valley. We went across the valleys and over the hilltop green. We met with Timmy Lacey, Sean Hogan and Dan Green, Johnny Mylan and his gallant men. They kept the green flag flying. Farewell to Tipperary, to the Galty Mountain Line. Dublin Mountains, the rebels on the run. We hunt at night and morning, we're outlaws but free men. We thread a week the mountain till the sun was rising high. Farewell to Tipperary, to the Galty Mountain High. I bid farewell to Oakland Mill, I never more will see. And to the Galty Mountains, that oftentimes shelter me. For the men that fought for freedom and died without a sight, may the cause be never forgotten, to the Galty Mountain High.
We'll have a selection on the accordion from a young man from the lower end of the town, Cork Street, in fact, Thomas Kiley. And he's going to give us a little selection on the accordion. Come on, Thomas. I think it's time we called on the lady of the house to give us a song. And I'd like to introduce the lady herself, Katie Dineen.
How far do I keep this out to me?
I've a nice little cotton, a small bit of land. Hello. And a place by the side of the sea. And I care about no one because I believe that nobody cares about me. My peace is destroyed and I'm fairly annoyed by a lassie who works in the town. She sighs every day as she passes the way. Do you want your lobby washed down?
Do you want your lobby washed down, Conshine? Do you want your lobby washed down?
The other day the old landlord came by for his rent. I told him no money I had. He said 'twas unfair for to ask me to pay, for the times are so awfully bad. He seemed discontent with not getting his rent, and he shook his big head with a frown. Says he, I'd take half, but says I, with a laugh, do you want your old lobby washed down?
Do you want your old lobby washed down, Conshine? Do you want your old lobby washed down?
Says he, I'd take half,
but says I, with a laugh, do you want your old lobby washed down?
These young lads so bashful, when they go out courting, they seem to be so very shy. For to kiss a young maid, sure they seem half afraid, but they would if they could end the sly. But with me I do things in a different way. I don't give a nod or a frown. For when I goes to court, I says, here goes for sport. Do you want your old lobby washed down?
Do you want your old lobby washed down, Conshine? Do you want your old lobby washed down?
For when I
goes to court, I says here goes the sport. Do you want your old lobby washed down, Conshine?
Now we have almost come to the end of our evening, and our next guest is a very shy lady, a very personal friend of mine over the years. I'd like to introduce to you Maura Kiley, and she's going to sing Shall My Soul Pass Through Old Ireland. Very good. Give her a big round of applause there, ladies and gentlemen.
In a dreary Brixton prison, where an Irish rebel lay, by his side a priest was standing, ere his soul should pass away. And he softly murmured, Father, as he clasped him by the hand, Tell me, Father, tell me truly, shall my soul pass through Ireland? Shall my soul pass through old Ireland, through Cork's own city grand? Shall it see the old cathedral where St. Finbar took his stand? Shall it see that little chapel where I pledged my heart on hand? Tell me, Father, tell me truly, shall my soul pass through Ireland? 'Tis for love of dear old Ireland, in this prison cell I lie. 'Tis for love of dear old Ireland, in a foreign land I die. When you meet my little daughter, won't you make her understand? Tell me, Father, tell me truly, shall my soul pass through Ireland? Shall my soul pass through old Ireland, through Cork's own city grand? Shall it see the old cathedral where St. Finbar took his stand? Shall it see that little chapel where I pledged my heart on hand? Tell me, Father, tell me truly, shall my soul pass through Ireland?
Right, here in the local district of Macomb, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very interesting little village called Ballinagree. And around the area, there's a very noted song of the district by the name of Carrigullagh. And Con here is going to give us a rendering of the tons of Carrigullagh, isn't it?
Yes.
And
by Carrigullagh yellow, one fine summer morning I strayed to view the green fields and trees that afford a great shade. 'Twas there I espied a harmless smiling dame, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. To view a nice girl, it being in the evening late, I waited a while outside Jack Sullivan's gate. To welcome me kindly, this charming young lassie she came, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. And at Ballinagree, when I'll see her coming to pray, my heart gets delighted with this charming young lassie to stray. She's free from all pride, and all that I'm glad of that same, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. And 'tis down by the line, my darling, goes herding her kine. You'd long to be nearer to hear her singing so fine. Her notes without rival the nightingale's melodious strain, and for tons of bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. And if I and my darling together alone had been, We traveled the mountains all to the top of Sifing. From kissing her sweet lips I could never restrain, and fortune's a bright gold, of course, I won't tell her name. And when I and my girl in wedlock we bought her joined, with the clergy well paid for the labour considered so light, until such indeed her name I will not disclaim, but without any gold, of course, I will tell her name.
Good night. We're waiting to go for a walk out the back, don't you? Mm. Walk away out there.
Yes.
And we have come to the end of a very pleasant evening here at the home of Dick and Katie Dineen. I'm sure you all enjoyed yourselves over the past couple of hours. It was a great bit of entertainment. I'm sure you had a great bit of crack. I'm sure I'm speaking for everyone on the floor when I thank Katie and Dick and their family for having us along here this evening and providing such a great evening of entertainment, and not alone that, but providing us with a cup of tea and plenty of refreshments. And thank you very much, Dick and Katie. Yeah, yeah. Before I hand you over to Dick, I'd just like to say it is great to be here this evening, and you know, on my own behalf, just to thank you all for being such a great audience. I had no problem with you, and you all came up when you were asked to do so and everything. So with that, I think Dick is going to sing a song for us as well before he leave, and I'll hand you over to Dick. So with that, all the best, lads, everybody.
Well, I want to thank you all for coming here, the musicians and the singers, and Dan Joy Kelleher, and I want to thank Paddy Healy for doing MC, and I suppose that's the whole lot, and I'll try an old verse of a song before we'll finish up. My feet are here in Broadway, this blessed harvest morn, but oh, the ache that's in my heart for the place where I was born. My weary hands are blistered from working cold and heat, but oh, to swing a scythe today in a field of Irish wheat. Had I my chance to wander back our own king's abode, it soon I'd see the hawthorn tree down the old bog road. When I was young and restless, my mind was ill at ease, through dreaming of America and the gold beyond the seas. Oh, sorrow, take their money, it's hard to find the same, but what's the world to any man if no one speaks his name? I've had my day, and here I am, a building bricks per load, along 3,000 miles away from the old bog road. My mother died last springtime, when Ireland's fields were green. The neighbour said her waking was the finest ever seen. Sure, the dewdrops and primroses piled high above her bed, and Ferns Church was crowded when her funeral mass was said. But here was I in a Broadway, a building bricks per load, when they carried out her coffin down the old bog road. A life's a weary puzzle, past finding out by man. I'll take the day for what it's worth, I'll do the best I can, since no one cared a rush for me. What need is there to moan? I'll go my way, I'll draw my pay, and I'll smoke my pipe alone. Each human heart must have its fling, though bitter be the load. So God be with you, Ireland, and the old bog road.